In this video, you'll learn how to get started with the DevExpress ASP.NET GridView control called the ASPX GridView. First, we'll create a new project using the template gallery and look at the demo app. Then, we'll create a new form, add the ASPX GridView, and bind it to data. After that, we'll look at how to customize the layout, add navigation from the demo app, and then further customize the grid to change the edit mode and show features like grouping, searching, and adding total summaries. So let's get started. The ASPX GridView can be added to a new or existing project. We'll use a DevExpress project template for this tutorial. Start by selecting the DevExpress template gallery from the Visual Studio project templates list. Set the project name and click Create. Select the ASP.NET tab, then select the Responsive Web Application from the ASP.NET Web Forms category. Click Run Wizard. The DevExpress ASP.NET Project Wizard helps you to customize project settings for themes, localization, and more. Once you click Create Project, the wizard will generate a ready-made web application with DevExpress ASP.NET controls. Let's take a look at the web app in the browser. This web app showcases responsive design and adaptive features of DevExpress ASP.NET controls. Click the link on the homepage to learn more about this project template. The web app also includes a fully populated ASPX GridView. To learn how to get started with the ASPX GridView control, let's add a new page to this web app. Right-click on the project from the Solution Explorer, select Add, and then select the Web Form with Master Page option. Set the name to Orders and Master Page File to the root.master page. This new page has several sections where you can add controls. Let's add a new ASPX GridView to the main page content area. You can add controls from the Design or Source View. Let's stay with the source view to see the ASPX GridView's HTML tag and its contents. From the toolbox, select ASPX GridView and drag and drop it into the page content area. Now, select the smart tag near the start of the ASPX GridView HTML tag. You can set up the GridView from the smart tag, or use the properties pane. However, I recommend the ASPX GridView Designer. Click the Designer link from the smart tag. This custom designer helps you to data bind, set up many common features, and customize the control. Let's bind our ASPX GridView to a database. From the data binding item, click the Data Source ID dropdown and choose New Data Source. The ASPX GridView can be bound to any standard Microsoft data source, DevExpress data source, or any data source which returns an IEnumerable interface. Select SQL Database and click OK. Click New Connection and enter the database details. I'll connect to my local SQL Express instance and choose the Northwind database. Then click Next to save the connection. From the list of tables, choose Orders. Then select the fields, Order ID, Customer ID, Order Date, Required Date, Ship Date, Freight, Ship Name, Ship Address, Ship City, and Ship Country. Then click the Advanced button and select the checkbox to generate, insert, update, delete statements. This will allow the ASPX GridView to provide editing features. Click OK, Next, Test the query, and click Finish. Now the ASPX GridView is data bound. It has created a data source and identified the key field property too. Let's take a look at the columns. The ASPX GridView has auto-generated the columns and also set the primary key column, order ID, to read only. We can also modify other columns here. For example, the customer ID field is the primary key for the customers table. Let's set it to read only to prevent any edits. The ASPX GridView has also created date time columns for the date-base fields such as order date. You can choose from many column types including binary image, color edit, spin edit, and more. The freight cost is a type of money field in our database. Let's improve this column in our ASPX GridView. Using the Change To dropdown, we'll set it to the Spin Edit column type. This will allow the end user to edit the values using spin buttons. We can also change the display format string to C for currency. Click OK. And let's take a look at these changes in the browser. The ASPX GridView now displays all of the orders and the freight column displays as currency values. Out of the box, the ASPX GridView provides paging with a built-in pager. Sorting an ascending or descending order. You can also sort multiple columns by holding down the Shift key. You can move around the columns using your mouse. Now, let's enhance the layout of this page. Since the left panel area is not being used on this page, we can remove it. This will also give the ASPX GridView extra space to the right, so we'll need to address the width too. In Visual Studio, you can set the width from the Properties pane. However, let's use the Source view. As you start typing, Visual Studio's IntelliSense will help and display the available properties. If we type W, then the width setting is displayed. We can set it to a value of 100 pixels, but let's set it to 100% so it fills the width of the content area. Now let's remove the left panel content area. And let's also enable editing in the ASPX GridView. We can do that from the designer, but let's use the smart tag and enable the Show Edit, New, and Delete checkboxes. Let's take a look in the browser. Now our left panel content area is removed and the grid spans the entire width. We can also edit using the ASPX GridView. Click the Edit link on a row and an edit form is displayed. The Freight column is displayed as a spin edit control. Now let's fix the navigation issue. Currently, we can't click on the top menu to navigate to this orders page. Go to the solution view and in the app data folder, open the application menu data source file. Add a new sitemap node item. Set the URL to the orders.aspx page and the title to orders. Now we have a new option at the top to navigate to orders, as well as the other items. Now let's look at the ASPX GridView's other editing options. In the editing section of the feature browser, you can see the available editing modes supported by the ASPX GridView. So besides the edit form layout, you have the option to use inline editing where each cell can be edited within the row. You can also display the edit form in a separate pop-up dialog. The ASPX GridView also supports batch editing. This mode allows you to edit the ASPX GridView on the client side and batch the changes for approval before sending them to the server. Let's explore batch edit mode. With batch editing mode enabled, you can double-click on a cell and begin editing the data immediately. This removes the need for the edit button. However, let's keep the Delete button and enable the New button. Let's take a look at batch editing in the browser. Now we can make changes to cells by clicking on them. For example, we can change the city from Lyon to Paris. You can also move to other pages and make modifications without having to update the database. For visual reference, the pending changes are highlighted in green an account is displayed on the Preview Changes button. Let's mark a few rows to be deleted. These changes are batched locally on the client side, and we can commit them to the database by clicking Save Changes or click Cancel Changes to abandon the edits. Now let's explore grouping. From the designer, we can see the ASPX GridView also supports grouping. Let's enable the Show Group panel checkbox and take a look in the browser. The grouping panel allows you to group by columns. For example, if you group by country, then you can see all the orders from Argentina or from France and so forth. We can also enable various filtering options. Let's enable the header filter and the search panel and see how they work in the browser. The filter panel searches within the entire grid, all rows and columns. For example, if I type the letters L, O, N, then all items matching this search term will be returned. This includes the City of London, as well as customers and ships containing these letters. The header filter allows you to filter by column. We can filter the country by France, which then limits the cities columns to only cities in France. We can continue to filter and select Lyon as the city for a granular search criteria. Let's enable one more feature, summaries. The ASPX GridView can calculate and display summary information for your data source. We'll create a total summary item to calculate the average cost of the freight column. From the Feature Browser's Summary section, first enable the Show Footer checkbox. Then click the Total Summary link below it. This takes you to the Items tab. Click and add a new ASPX summary item. Set the field name and Shown in Column Properties to Freight. For summary type, you have several options, including sum, min, max, count, average, and custom to. Select average and click OK. Let's add another summary from the source view. I'll copy and paste the current summary item and change the field name and shown in column properties to order ID. I'll set the summary type to count. Let's see the summaries in the browser. Now the footer area is enabled and it contains the summary information, the average cost for freight, as well as a total count of all orders. And that's it for this video. To learn more about this topic, make sure to check out the links available in the description. You can also learn more about our ASP.NET Web Forms controls by watching other videos from this playlist or visiting the documentation on our website. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified whenever we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.